Thank you for the invitation and for this opportunity to speak to all of you, right? I am totally aware that you are waiting for lunch. And I'm also totally aware that the people behind can't really hear that well. But I hope that you will engage with me, because I think this is more for me to tell you a journey about leadership. It's not so much, you know, talking about the signs. In fact, I was listening to the signs before my session, and I was thinking, wow, I'm learning so many things, okay? So for those of you who have been here, I'm going to quiz you on what you heard from the previous speakers, okay? All right, first and foremost, okay, how much salt are you allowed to take a day? Hey, the people behind, quick. People behind, anyone? 5, 2, no, 4, did I hear 4? Okay, 5 grams, all right. We are all clever people, right? Yes, lah. We're all doctors, okay. But when you go for your lunch and you look at the food served to you, how do you know it is 5 grams? Do you know? Okay. So if you and I are clever people and we don't know, how do we expect anyone else to know? So that is the message I want to bring across about leadership, right? And I'm going to just tell you, because it is about sustainable leadership, right? Sustainable goals. Okay, these are the challenges that we're going to have, all of us. We said aging, rising health expenditure. I think nobody has mentioned this one, but remember this, carbon emission for our future generations, right? Very, very important. Health workforce. I heard this one. Someone in the earlier talks talked about health workforce. We all have a shortage, okay? And the worst thing is a shortage is, on top of the shortage is a burnout, right? This one. Many people I know have left healthcare or just feel totally burnt out after the pandemic. Okay, we will talk a little bit about why. And this one, technological advancement. Okay, I know some of you are not my generation, but for people in the older generation, whenever there's a new technology, how many of us say, yay, new technology? How many of us say, oh my gosh, I have to learn another new thing? How many of you say, oh, I am tired of learning a new thing, okay? So think about it, technology, that is actually a challenge. But I will also tell you why that challenge is very, very important for leadership, okay? So all these things interact together. I'm going back to my salt story, yeah? So if you and I don't know what is 5 grams, okay? You and I don't know. What generally is the next thing that we do? We ask the experts, right? We go to the speakers and say, so what do you do? But let me tell you this, the dear experts, it's not their role to do these things. They are experts in the science. So that's where the rest of us, okay, and I'm not talking about one person. Leadership is not talking about one person. Leadership is a group. And leadership is many generations. It is not one generation, right? We build up leaders from the ground. Who are the ones who might have a bright idea? It might be your doctors on the ground. It might be the nurse on the ground, okay? So for examples, what do you think can make people know that something is truly 5 grams of salt? Where would you start? Anyone got ideas? Anybody? Okay, if you don't have an idea, what would you do? Yes, idea. Less tasty food. Okay, less tasty food probably is the correct answer, but you know less tasty food will not be popular, right? Why? So what about an idea where leadership has to distill this? Ask the expert. Why is it so important? Convince me that salt, 5 grams, is very important. Now, if you convince me, then we can have a campaign where everybody comes up with ideas. How do you, you know, start in a school, start in a home, start in somewhere. Maybe just start with the school, right? And that's where, when we started Sengkang, I built Sengkang Hospital and we engaged the community around. That's how we started. We went to the schools. We spent a few hours just teaching nutrition. Why is it effective? Because they went to tell their mothers and their grandmothers, "Grandma, my teacher said you're not supposed to eat this." Okay? So that's how we could potentially make change. It's not at our expert level. Okay? Now, doctors, how many patients can you save every day? How many patients do you see every day? 100. Okay, I can save 100 patients every day. But if I do this salt right, how many patients can you save every day who will not get hypertension, who will not come to the hospital? How many do you think? Less than 100? More than 100? Which one? How many of you say more than 100 if I do it right, okay? People at the back, what do you think? Less than 100? If every day today, as a doctor, I save 100 patients, if I get my policy right, I get my leadership level right, will I save more than 100 people? Yes. Yes, of course. Because today, I cannot see 200 patients. Why can't I see 200 patients? Because there's a limit to how much I can do. There's a limit to your queues, right? You have people coming in, going out, but there's a limit to your queue. Okay, so these are the things for sustainable care. We need to do some of these things. Reduce disease burden. Don't let them even get sick. All right, and this is where I need to acknowledge that you are doing a better job than we are, because you do this. You do the 15 precinct. The 15, you know, a certain number of patients get a certain number of clinics, right? That's what I heard. We are just starting. That's why Vijaya said we can share, we can learn from each other. And that is, again, the leadership position, right? Many places are strong in hospital care. Okay, I'm an anaesthetist. Maybe in the whole world, I'm probably the only anaesthetist who has done 2 craniopagus separation. So, what's the big deal, right? Today, we're talking about public health, what you're doing, so that people don't even fall sick. They don't even have to come and see me. That is success. All right? That is success. Okay, we don't want patients in our hospital. We want them at home. But if you want patients at home, what must you build? More hospital? No. More nurses? Yes. And more what? Social support. You need to build social support. You need to understand finance and social, right? The next one I'm going to quickly touch on is performance management, right? We need data, but look at this, okay? US spends so much money on healthcare. Can you and I afford that? We can't. You know the saying, I worked for 60 years to earn money. I spend it in the last 10 years of my life. In what? In dying. Okay? So, that is not sustainable. We really, really cannot go down that route. Okay? So, in sustainable healthcare, right, we really need to think about how to stop that from happening. And I see it across the world. The last couple of things, okay? How gross, what is gross? Is get rid of stupid stuff. Get rid of stupid stuff. How many of you at work, okay, at least once a week say, "Ayo, this is so stupid. Why am I doing this?" Okay, how many of you at least once a week, once a month, you sort of say, "Oh, why is this so stupid?" Okay? But do you ever voice it up? Do you bring it up? And after you bring it up, your boss says, Great, you have a great idea. Please go and do it. What do we usually say to that? No. Thank you. I have no time. I'm a doctor. Does that sound familiar? A few of you are smiling, okay? You don't want to put up your hands, but I know, right? The problem with this is we are clever to talk, but we don't want to move. We don't want to take the effort. Now, that again is leadership, right? It's something that all of us can learn. It's something that you can build up among people so that we are all sharing the burden together. We are not pushing things to other people. Because if you think that you have great ideas, you must be willing to do it, okay? So look at this. The technology moves up so fast, but we add technology to our old way of working and we have not reviewed the way we are working. So you basically add on more things, right? I used to walk like this. Now I have to carry my laptop and still walk like this. And tomorrow I have to carry my laptop plus my monitors and I start walking like this. But I never review why I'm walking this path. Maybe all this technology should help me not to have to do things the same way. So we add, and we never remove. When something goes wrong, when there's a mad error, what do? You say, now two people got to check, right? Still wrong, three people got to check. Soon, we can't move, okay? So all these things make a difference. We spend so much on research, but not on the implementation. Okay? We spend so much on research. I'm not saying you should not spend, but think about how the research can be implemented. So finally, I want to say today, leadership is about each one of us here. It's not one or two people, and it's not from the top down anymore. It's everybody's job, right? And how do we train everybody so that they can be a good leader, right? That's where we come to this, okay? What got you here won't get you there, all right? What got us here won't get us there because the world has changed. IT and technology has changed. So this is what Vijaya was talking about. This is my path, okay? I was a clinician. When I became a good doctor, they said, okay, you go and run your department. And then after that, they say, you go and do patient safety. After that, they say, you go and build a hospital and run the hospital. But we have no training. We have no training. And then doctors say, why should I know about finance? Why do I need to know about, you know, all these other things, risk management? Because it all makes a difference. How the money goes around, how you're funded, makes a difference to the healthcare that you deliver, right? So we don't have to be experts, but we need to know a little bit about everything. And you have to be part of it and be the person who runs it, okay? So it's something that we are happy to work with you if there are opportunities, and I'm sure you can contribute to it as well. Right? So I'm just going to end here, and I hope I did convince you that leadership is about bringing people together, is about understanding human behaviors, it's about a style, it's not about sheer knowledge. I end by asking you this. If you didn't know any of the guidelines today, where would you go? If you needed to know the hypertension guidelines, where would you go? Let's face it, our handphones. Knowledge is now all on your handphone. Leadership is about how to make that knowledge change lives and change practice. Knowledge is there, okay? So thank you very much.
தன்னை அறிய தனக்கு ஒரு கேடு இல்லை, தன்னை அறியாமல் தானே கெடுவான். தன்னை அறியும் அறிவே அறிந்த பின் தன்னை அர்ச்சிக்க தான் இருந்தானே. திருமந்திரத்தில் ரொம்ப அழகாக சொல்லியிருப்பாங்க, அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் ஆஃப் செல்ஃப், அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் ஆஃப் த குளோபல், அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் ஆஃப் யூனிவர்ஸ், அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் ஆஃப் என்வைரன்மெண்ட் வில் கிரியேட் குட் பாலிசிஸ் அண்ட் குட் லீடர்ஷிப், அண்ட் குட் லீடர்ஷிப் வில் அச்சீவ் சோ மெனி குட் கோல்ஸ். Beautifully presented by Dr. Madam. Thank you, Madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Now we request Dr. Shanmugasundaram sir, Joint Director, HEB, to facilitate the speaker. Thank you, Dr. Charan sir, Director ICM, for moderating the session.